New Britain, Connecticut is the site for the NEC Soccer Championships. This is our second semifinal. Shot! Score! The Bulldogs strike first. Finds his man, Kolarik, in the middle. And that shot, goal! What a bullet from Nick Kolarik, and we're tied at one.
In a small window, watch it again, kept it low, and I think that's the key, keeping it low.
Pablo Medina. And that's headed, and! Wow! Ryan Byers.
I mean, look at it again. It's not, he's in the middle of this group. See, it comes over the two Bryant players. And he just turned enough.
The header, goal! With a minute and a half left, Bryant ties it up. Shane Murphy lobbed it in there. Wow.
18, Connor Norad.
Connor Norad. We are going to be headed to penalty kicks. Shot. Score! Against Chris Kanab. Who's the better poker player? It's in. No good. Murphy scores. Bryant 3 for 3. Medina. No! And Bryant wins it. Hit the crossbar.
Very much, Dave. A couple of very happy Bryant Bulldogs. Chris Knob first, the goalkeeper, who certainly saved the day. In the penalty kick situation, talk about your strategy and how you were so successful.
I mean, I owe it all to my coaching staff. They prepared me every day. They helped me every time. We do PKs frequently, and my goalie coach has been awesome. Chambers has been awesome this whole season. It's just reading the players, trying to play some mind games, step left and go the same way, you know, just try to trick the players.
I noticed that jab step on the first one. You jab left and went right. Did you have a feeling they were going to go to your right?
Usually a lot of players will look for your first step, so I thought if you go right, if I take my step left, because I thought I'd go that way. So I just tried to bait him that way to my right, and then I went there.
How did this team persevere late in the game when you know, moments left and you're down a goal?
It just goes back to everything we work on every day in practice, the coaches and everything. We work so hard in practice. We stress for moments like this. We're ready for this. We had a talk in the middle of the season that gave them that extra 10%. We definitely gave it today, so I'm definitely proud of my boys.
And you got one more game to give more than 100%. That's on Sunday. Congratulations.
Thank
good luck.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
All right. A great effort. And here comes Seamus Purcell. Seamus, first of all, the team perseveres. Very little time left in regulation. What's going through your mind?
I think, to be honest, I'm thinking that we might have just left it too late, you know. But this team has done this all year. They've stayed together. They've worked hard. And I was just shocked, like most people, I think, when the ball went in the back of the net with a minute and a half left.
Penalty kick situation. You got a goalkeeper, he's wearing shorts, he's oblivious to the situation, I guess.
Yeah, he's just, look, he's a tremendous goalkeeper. Dusan, our goalie coach, has done an unbelievable job, and not just him, but the other two keepers. And Chris is going to be all-conference and all-American by the time he's a senior, I know that for sure.
How do you top this and win on Sunday?
Just like you said, win on Sunday. And I just want to give a shout-out to Mike Casper and his team. Unbelievable team, dynamic. You know, you could say maybe they could have squeaked it, you know, but they did a great job. He's a great coach. I want to just say, you know, well done to them. I know it's kind of consolation, and we just go on to Sunday and another St. Francis team to play.
We look forward to a great match. Good luck on Sunday.
Thanks very much.